Hello everyone.
Welcome you all at online tutorial classes by Tishitu. I Pankaj Chawla, once again here to share knowledge with you. Today we are going to discuss important and interesting facts about one of the apps of Matlab. PID Tuner is one of the application available in Matlab software. So today we are going to learn how to tune PID with the help of PID Tuner app of Matlab. In the previous class, we discussed about the tuning of PID by changing the value of constant KP, KI and KD. Whenever we use PID, the major problem is the tuning of the value of these constants, because the performance of PID controller depends on the value of these constants. Are you ready to move on? So let's start. In the previous class, we considered this block diagram for our study. We continue with this only in this class also. A PID controller defined with the help of equation KP plus KI into 1 by S plus KD into S. PID controller uses are widely, so it is easily adopted in any system. Sometime controller equation used as usual and sometime it used with some modification like this. Take a KP common and equation can be written as like this. On simplifying we get KP into 1 plus 1 upon TI into S plus TD into S, where TI known as reset time and TD known as derivative or rate time. So depend on the observation, researcher may use any one form of this equation. Now we move towards MATLAB to see the use of PID tuner. Once you open a MATLAB, open the same code that were we used in last class. So this is a code. Initially we set KP, KI, KD equal to 0. Instead of inbuilt function PID, this time we will going to use the equation of controller, that is KP plus KI into 1 by S plus KD into S. So if someone wants to work with TI and TD, easily modify the equation as we discussed. Now run this code. So the variables used in this code are saved in the workspace, as we can see over here. So that is used by the PID tuner to start working on our code. Close the graph, move towards the apps tab of MATLAB here. In that, select PID tuner. Then a new window will come up as a graphic user interface of PID tuner. Initially, it will show the graph of a dummy plant. Here we have an option of change plant. Select it and click on import to see all variables saved in workspace. Select TFP name variable as it had a graph of our system without controller to tune it. So it's a step response of our system. Initially, by default, a proportional controller include with the system. Here is the option of type of controller. It indicates P type, means it start with the proportional controller. We set KP equal to 2 as we same do in the code also. Then we change the value of KP with the help of slide bar option of response time. As the value of KP increase, the rise time of response improving gradually, as we can notice on the change in the shape of response. We can also observe the various parameters related to our response in the option of show parameters over here. Value of KP, rise time, settling time, overshoot, peak response. As we notice that the rise time is very small, but overshoot become 83%, which is not desirable. So as we discussed, to overcome the overshoot, now include the derivative controller along with the proportional controller. So click the option of type and you have many combinations of controller over here. Select PD controller now. Once we selected it, a new slide bar named transient response activates. By changing it, a value of KD change, and we can notice that a transient behavior of the system improves, means the overshoot get reduced. Again, as we can notice the value of parameters, overshoot become 1.41%, which is acceptable, but still the final value less than 1. So to achieve final steady state value, Now include the PID controller by selecting it in the option of type of controller. As we selected it and again notice the value of parameters in which peak value means the final value of the system becomes 1. Overshoot near to 0.0796% only and rise time 0.0869 seconds. So according to the value of parameters, our system is tuned at these values of KP, KI and KD. We can also measure these parameters on a graph itself with the same process. Just right click on the graph and you have a options in which characteristic option will give the option of rise time, peak value, overshoot, settling time. As here we measure the rise time on the graph indicates same value 0.0869 seconds. If anyone wanna see the transfer function of the system, that is the value of TFP selected by us, so here is the option to see the transfer function. If someone wanna measure the value of TI and TD, then here is the option of change form. If we select standard form, then we can observe the value of TI and TD over here. Now use these value of KP, KI, KD in a code file and run it to observe the tuned step response of the system and measure the value of rise time over here also. It give approx value near to 0.0865 seconds and measure the steady state value which gives exactly 1. So in this way we tune PID for our system using the PID Tuner app of MATLAB. We will learn more about PID optimization in the next coming lectures using algorithm. I hope you enjoy learning with me to gain more knowledge. Stay tuned with us.
Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon as we keep on posting informative content like this. You can also get certification from Tishitu Research Center if you finish minimum of 10 videos from the playlist. To get more information about this, connect to us at tishitu@gmail.com.